A burning car was not going to stop this hero from going back. This rescue is video you're only seeing on News 4 tonight. Good evening. Thank you for joining us. I'm Steve Savard.
And I'm Samantha Jones. As if the rescue being caught on camera wasn't incredible enough, only News 4's Vinton Blandon was there for a thank you of a lifetime. Vinny, understandably, this was an incredibly emotional moment.
That embrace, Sam and Steve, happened right here, and it was certainly something to see. For the people who did see it, they might have seen it last more than 8 minutes and probably thought it was just any old hug, but I got to tell you, this one was filled with love and gratitude.
It's all good.
Such raw emotion wrapped inside a tight hug among strangers.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
But what could bring these three so close?
Grab him! Grab him! Grab him! Pull! Pull! Pull!
Even with the explosions going on, Antonio Morgan hopped out of his car to help the person inside a burning car on Interstate 70 near Lucas Hunt.
Just immediately just rushed into what I know, you know, try to get him up out the car as fast as I can.
Morgan struggled as he helped the man he'd soon realized was buckled into the driver's seat.
I'm pulling him, he ain't coming. Then I seen this seatbelt, the smoke was right there in my face, so I unhooked the seatbelt. Pulled him out.
With Morgan nearly stuck inside the car, another man used a fire extinguisher to help stop the flames.
And flames started right after the smoke. It was hot. It started to get hot and heated up in there. Then it bust. Boom. You hear that old something blew up or something under the hood.
Inside the fire was 23-year-old Keelan Robinson.
Man, that last pull, I was out of energy. I was rushing. My adrenaline was rushing, man.
Morgan managed to pull out Robinson. Robinson's mom would get a call and see the video 15 minutes later.
When I seen the video, I just broke out in tears and just like emotions, so many emotions.
She would meet her son's hero about 2 hours later.
If he would have not been persistent with that and not stuck on that, my son would be dead right now and I'd be planning a funeral.
She and her sister are grateful.
My guardian angel saved my baby. This man, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus.
She and Morgan are parents. Both are close to their children. Watching Morgan save Robinson was Morgan's 14-year-old son, who happened to record the video.
I was proud for my dad, but at the same time, I was thinking if the dude was gonna be straight.
Robinson is recovering. His mom and aunt can't wait to introduce him to his extended family member.
If it was not for this man being persistent, going back and forth, not giving up, my nephew would not be here today. So he is definitely a part of our family now.
The only person missing from that story that you did not see, obviously, was Keelan Robinson. But I did just talk to him about 5 minutes ago, and I asked him about his injuries. He told me the only thing he's dealing with tonight is a small headache. We hope to talk to him tomorrow. Reporting live, Vinton Blandon, News 4.